Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. A lot of people talk about autism, but not everyone understands what it is. Autism Spectrum Disorder, or ASD, affects how people communicate with and relate to others. This isn't the same as being shy or not knowing what to say. Most people with autism don't understand some of the basic social conventions that others take for granted. They might have trouble making eye contact, holding a conversation, or recognizing gestures. And over one-third of people with ASD are nonverbal, meaning they don't use speech. Along with communication issues, people with autism often like to follow certain patterns or repeated behaviors. Many have a sensitivity to bright light or loud noises, and others have physical problems like trouble walking or picking up small objects. Some have intellectual disabilities, but about half have average or above average IQs. It's also common for people with autism to have a great long-term memory for certain details, and many excel in math, science, music, or art. With such a wide variety of symptoms, no two people with ASD are alike. The behaviors vary so much that they used to be classified as different disorders. One was Asperger syndrome, where people obsess over particular topics, miss nonverbal social cues, and may not understand appropriate social behavior. In 2013, scientists realized that the boundary between Asperger syndrome and some of the other disorders was fuzzy, so they decided to put them all under one name. This made it easier to diagnose autism, which is important. The younger someone is diagnosed, the earlier they can get help. In fact, many children who have autism will show signs by just 2 years old, including not responding to their name, avoiding eye contact, and flapping their hands or rocking repeatedly. Even though there is no cure for ASD, therapy and medication can help people adjust. Scientists are also doing clinical trials to find other solutions. They've learned that one out of every 68 children in the US has the disorder, but they still aren't sure what causes it. Autism is over 4 times more common in boys than girls, and most scientists think genes play a role because it often runs in families. Some people with ASD have abnormal chromosomes, but this can't be the whole story. There are people with the same gene changes who don't have autism. Other possible causes include having older parents, being exposed to high levels of testosterone in the womb, and having complications during pregnancy or birth. It may even have something to do with gut bacteria, since many autistic people have gastrointestinal issues. But most likely, it's a combination of many factors. The one thing scientists know for sure is that vaccines do not cause autism. No matter why it happens, ASD is being diagnosed at a higher rate every year. This doesn't mean it's becoming more common. It just means more people are aware of the condition and getting diagnosed early. And awareness is crucial. The more we learn about autism, the more we can understand and relate to those who have it. It's important to note that people with ASD deserve the same respect, fairness, and chances that people without ASD receive. This will help people with ASD adapt and grow in our communities. We've put some resources in the description if you would like to learn more about ASD and figure out what you can do to help. Is there another disorder or any other topic you would like us to talk about? Let us know in the comments section below. And if you would like to learn more about OCD, we made a video on just that. Check it out. Or if they obsess with safety, they might force themselves to check that the doors are locked and that the stove is off dozens of times before they can leave the house. My name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.